Episode 2661, Write Your Own Love Story.
It's time to train for life and love your journey. In this episode of Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, you'll learn new ways to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew your mind, body, and spirit. Please welcome your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people drive. Happy, happy day. I hope you're ready for something exciting to happen for your marriage. In your relationship, it is important to work on it every single day. Write your own love story. For those of you who are brand new to Create You Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already didn't have the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple strategy, everyday solutions to live, love, and impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. When during your days do you write your own love story? You know, life can be chaotic and busyness can lead the pack. Don't let your love go down with the sun. You may have excuses, busyness, deadlines, bills, children, laundry, dishes, and dinner. All can be the culprit on the sun going down on your marriage. Think about it. How many times has any one of those gotten in the way of your marriage? Maybe it started with a fight because you didn't know where you wanted to go for dinner. No one would make a decision. As simple it is, let's just put some food in our mouth to nourish our bodies. But for some reason, it's the end of the world and it's all out war. But see, I want you to think about this because we're not talking about it. And if you're not talking about it, you're not thinking about it, which means you cannot make your marriage better. So you have to be ever so vigilant and stay the course to building a strong foundation every day. This stuff does not happen overnight. You know, I haven't been feeling well over the last few weeks. And I found myself short-spoken, kind of with an edge to my voice last night, truly for no reason. I was just tired. I was done. I was spent. I was doing everything for everybody else. And I was like, you know what? I just want to sit down. My head, well, I can't hear myself. When I'm talking to you, I have no idea what I sound like. So I probably still sound like I don't have much of a voice and I'm straining. I'm not straining as hard, but it's still weird. And I'm doing my best to get well, but man, I've just got one thing after another and it just has built upon itself and it's frustrating for me. Well, of course, guess what happened? I got frustrated and I got short with my husband. Now, that wasn't fair to my hubby, nor right of me to do it. So instead of pushing back, he knew I was ill and just let it all slide. But if you want to be honest, sometimes we like to challenge our spouses, right? We like to push when they're weak. Now, he could have taken that opportunity to do so, yet he chose to support and to let go. So guess what I did? I apologized. I went in while he was getting ready for bed and I said, hun, I said, I was short with you tonight. There was no reason for that. I said, I just don't feel good. I'm tired. I said, I'm sorry. It was wrong of me to be jerky just because I didn't feel like it. This is how we decided to write our own love story in that brief moment. He was kind, considerate, and he just let it all slide. Now, he could have called me out on it, but he didn't. He just let it slide. But then I owned it, and I went and apologized. Both of which was good for both of us, right? So we wrote our own love story. See, you got to write your own love story every single day. You've got to build consistently every day that letter that you want to live, and that's your love story. That is your Kiss to Keep It Simple strategy. Write your own love story. And you get to choose. You could choose to be a jerk. I would beg you not to be, because then why are you in a relationship? But if you really want to build, and I know you're going to have disagreements. I know you're going to have discussions that get a little heated. I get that. That's called real life, right? And that's what we do here. We tell it like it is, and we're honest, real, and raw. And that's why you can go out and change the world, because we're not sugarcoating anything, even though we love sugar. We've got to look at what's really happening in our marriages and how can we make them better? How can we respond better as a spouse So therefore, your spouse will also in turn want to respond differently. This is all about the B's of a love story. But remember this, you have to be a willing participant. Yet at the same time, it still can start with you. Sometimes it takes some encouragement for your spouse to get on board or understand how important this is, and you've got to make the first move. And that's okay. So don't sit around and say, oh, I'm just going to wait till he's ready, because he may never be ready. You may have to be the role model. You may have to show him 200 times before he gets it. Now, if you're in the position within your relationship to have an honest heart-to-heart conversation, great. But you know what? Some people are not. You may be in a position right now that you're walking on eggshells. Maybe you're walking on broken glass and you just don't know what to expect. So start treating your spouse the way you want to be treated. But I know it's easier not to. And a lot of us go down that road instead. I'm asking you to write your own love story, to be different. Number one, be who you are becoming. You don't want to sacrifice who you are. You don't want to compromise who God has called you to be and who he is grooming you to be so you can go out and impact the world that you touch. But you also can't present yourself as one type of a person yet be another one. That's a lie and is disrespectful both to yourself and to your spouse. So don't put on this masquerade ball for your spouse acting like, oh, I'm the most precious thing there is and I don't ever get mad and I'm just, you know, so easy to get along with. And then all of a sudden you're tired 3 years into your marriage and now you're becoming this monster that he never knew. Your true colors are going to come out. So if you're trying to hide something, I promise you, your true colors are going to come out. No matter what you're hiding, no matter what it is, they will come out. Okay? I know I've seen it over and over and over again. It's happened in our marriage. It happens every single day. And so don't try to manipulate. Don't try to put on a front. Don't try to have that masquerade ball and be someone that you are not. Be who you are becoming. Now, I also have a note that says, for those of you who want to be a jerk, then you need to grow up. Put your big girl panties on. Enough is enough. And you know who you are. And maybe you're not a jerk all the time, but maybe in a certain circumstance, you're just a jerk. Well, then grow from that. Stop being such a jerk. Figure out a different way to handle things. And we all have those moments in our life. So learn from it, grow from it, because I promise you it's going to help in your marriage always. So be who you are becoming. Number two, break the chains of expectations. Just like you need to be who you are becoming, your spouse needs the same too. So make room by not placing expectations on your spouse. I did exactly that to my husband last night. That's why I went off. And it wasn't a bad thing. It just, I had this bite to my tone and I heard it even though I'm so congested in my head. And I was like, well, that was really rude and that was really stupid. Why did you do that? He's exhausted too. He's had a long week. And yesterday was just one of those hard, weird, freaky days. And he came home tired. And he's meeting his spouse who's even more tired. But it's not about comparison. It's not about me feeling worse than he is. It's not about him having a worse day than I was. It's about two of us coming together and being human and loving each other with no expectations. But see, I placed one on him. I wanted him to take care of everything. I didn't want to have to think about anything yet. I had to think about something and I had to be the brain in the evening and I didn't want to do that last night. And so I got fussy. And that's not right. Break the chains of expectations. You don't want to be the fussy jerk all the time. But you also want to be real and you want to be able to open that up both for yourself and for your spouse. It is so important because if you are pretending, if you are putting on that masquerade ball, not just for yourself, but for your spouse. I mean, it's a challenge when you do it for yourself. But when you start living that life with your spouse, we need a whole nother conversation. But one thing I can tell you is this. It doesn't lead to a strong marriage. Your marriage will dissolve over time. And it will become very, very weak. So be who you are becoming. Break the chains of expectations. No one wants to live under that umbrella. And finally, number three, bloom where you are planted as a couple. Yes, it's spring. And I got to tell you, I was outside and I was working the lawn and taking care of the gutters and doing all this fun plant stuff. And I was like, yeah, we got to bloom where you are planted as a couple. Because you know what? We got to clear the gutters when it comes to our marriage. And part of that is learning to bloom where we're planted. Life happens and things get messy. This is the real hard truth. However, that doesn't mean that you cannot grow together over time. That's really the key. Be willing to bloom. That's being wrong, right, indifferent, stumped, confused, loving, forgiving, grateful, and so many more in all areas of your life, not just when you're hanging out, but learn, meaning bloom together. Figure things out together. Try new things together. It's got to be together. Now, again, I come back though, because I could hear it already. But my spouse won't do what I'm doing. Yeah, I get that too. But you got to still keep working. And hopefully over time, you'll get to the position in your marriage where you can have a more honest conversation, meaning that you can say something and your spouse doesn't take offense to it. That's a hard line to draw because early in marriage, okay, when you're in your honeymoon phase, oh, everybody's listening. Everybody's so, oh, yes, I love you. You can't do anything wrong and you're so adorable and you're just perfect and I can't ever live without you and life just would be nothing. And I just, you know, it's all of that, right? And then all of a sudden real life hits. A year and a half, 2 years, if you're lucky, 3 years later. And all of a sudden, you're like, what just hit the fan? And now anything and everything you do together, apart, is wrong. It's just wrong. And if you haven't had that time to heal as a couple and come together as a couple, it takes a lot to get to that point. And I'm talking a lot, not 24 hours. I'm talking about years. Because there's healing and mending and broken hearts that need to come together. There's forgiveness that needs to happen. And not forgiveness at a point of what just happened, but at a point that happened 15 years ago. Marriage is tough, but it's beautiful. The man can balance the woman and the woman can balance the man. It's a beautiful thing. So write your own love story every day, not just when you feel like it, because guess what? You're not going to write. You're not going to be in it to win it. You're going to have more arguments than you are discussions. And really, are there really any differences between the two? Except wait, the intensity and who's right and who's wrong. That's the difference between an argument and discussion. If you're in an argument, you want to win. If you're in a discussion, you're looking for a solution. It's not about winning or losing. It's not about keeping score. So where are you in your marriage right now? Are you writing your love story every day? If you are, celebrate that. Go tell your spouse, hug your spouse and say, you know what, hun? I love writing our love story every single day. Sometimes you make me mad, but you know what? You make me smile more. That's an incredible statement. Steal it from me. Go tell your spouse that. But if you're one who says, gosh darn it, I'm not there, Christiane, don't feel like a failure. We're not having to reach a certain pinnacle to say we have a great marriage. Having a great marriage is showing up every single day for your spouse. So don't waste another minute. Go out and write your love story. Be present, be incredible. Be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious, blessed weekend. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.